Good morning, Reverend Father Principal Sir Clifford, our Vice Principal, Reverend Father Rector, Miss Anita, our Supervisor, teachers, and my dear friends.
Prayer enlightens us with positive thoughts. I now invite Miss Aarti to lead us into prayer.
Kindly take a proper posture. Join your hands. Close your eyes. Let us thank God for all the good that He has blessed us with. Let us ask Him to shower His blessings now and always on us, our family, our near and dear ones, as we pray together. Father, we thank you for the night and for the pleasant morning light, for rest and food and loving care, and all that makes the world so fair. Help us to do the things we should, to be to others kind and good. In all we do, in all we say, to grow more loving every day. Amen.
Thank you, Miss Aarti. Hope is a spur of life. It's a waking dream and inspiration to live life the best we can.
Hope gives you the courage and inspiration to work towards your dream.
If you have a strong aspiration, hope and faith, nothing can bring you down.
Christmas infuses hope, peace and trustful joy into mankind. We offer prayers and sing praises to God for all the gifts He has blessed us with.
It's the season to accomplish the teachings of Jesus, to bring hope to people and the places in the dark.
We, the students of Class 8D, proudly present to you
Hope is Born
When All is Forlorn.
Christmas was on its way, and a lot of preparations were going on in Anthony's house. The telephone rings and Anthony rushes to pick it up.
Hello, who is this?
Hey Anthony, it's me Josh. How's everyone doing?
Hi Josh, yeah, everyone is doing well. Just waiting for Christmas so that we all can have fun together.
Oh yes, even I am very excited. Eagerly waiting to see all of you.
Yeah, me too.
Okay then, see you all soon. Got to go. Till then, you guys take care.
Okay, Josh. See ya. And you take care too.
The next day, something really shocking awaits Anthony.
It was a snowy day. Anthony and his dad were having breakfast.
Then, Anthony's dad tells Anthony something that he wouldn't like to hear.
Anthony, Josh called me and he said that there's going to be a terrible snowstorm in his vicinity. He's also said that it might be difficult for him to come here. But don't worry, he will try his best.
After hearing this, Anthony was shocked.
Oh no! Now what will happen, Dad? If Josh doesn't come home, how will we celebrate Christmas together? I just hope that Josh comes for Christmas. I'm really missing him a lot.
Scene 2, at the market. Later that evening, Anthony and his parents went to the market for some Christmas shopping. Anthony's morose mood slightly got better after looking at all the pomp around. Once they reached the market, they started looking out for a Christmas tree.
A beautiful, glossy tree caught Anthony's attention. Anthony, very excited, ran towards the tree and shouted with joy.
Mom, Dad, you've got to see this. Look at this tree. It's so beautiful.
That indeed is a beautiful tree, Anthony.
Yes, and I'm sure that Josh would love it.
Anthony then remembered that Josh wouldn't be home for Christmas. He felt sad again.
Oh, Anthony, don't feel sad. And if Josh doesn't get to see it, he'll still be happy that we have such a beautiful tree.
Okay, Mom.
Hardly had they purchased the tree when Anthony saw a small crowd of children gathered nearby. Anthony was curious to know what was happening there.
bird machine.
Check.
Anthony took his parents' permission and went closer to check on what's happening. He was really surprised with what he saw. It was Santa! He was flocked by so many children, happily clinging to him, hugging him, and talking to him.
Mom, Dad, can I go and meet Santa, please?
Well, we're kind of in a hurry. We need to be back home before the snow gets too deep.
But since this is Santa, I guess we can spare some time.
Thank you, Dad. Thank you, Mom.
It seemed to take forever, but at last, it was finally Anthony's turn.
Well, well. And what would you like for Christmas, dear child?
I really wish that my brother Josh comes home for Christmas. But my mom and dad don't think he can make it due to the heavy snowstorm in his area. My brother lives in the hostel, and I never get to play and talk with him a lot. I always wait for his vacations so that he can come home here and enjoy. I really am missing him a lot, and I really want to see him for Christmas.
I usually don't deliver people on Christmas Eve, just toys. But I'll tell you what, tonight, before you go to sleep, make your wish on the biggest, brightest star in the sky. That's the wishing star.
Oh, wow. But will it really work, Santa?
You can never tell about wishes, so I don't make any promises. But it surely doesn't hurt to try.
Okay, Santa. Thank you.
Bye.
On their way home, Anthony talked about Santa's wishing star.
We all make wishes every now and then, son, but sometimes they just can't come true.
I'm going to try it anyway.
Scene 3. At home. That night after dinner, Dad put the Christmas tree in its stand. Anthony and his mom joined him in decorating it with colorful lights and balls and lots of tinsels.
Wow, Anthony. Must say, you've chosen the best Christmas tree ever.
Thank you, Dad.
While they were working, Anthony thought about something.
It would be so great if Josh was here to see our beautiful tree.
At night, Anthony went to his room upstairs and was just about to go to sleep. He was looking outside his window when he saw the wishing star right overhead. He was amazed.
Oh, wow! The wishing star is here!
So Anthony looked up at the bright star and made his wish.
Dear wishing star, please let my Christmas wish come true. I really wish that my brother Josh would come home on the Christmas Eve so that we all can be together and enjoy Christmas celebration.
After making his wish, Anthony went to sleep.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, drown your virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep.
When Anthony woke up,
and went downstairs, he saw a pair of shoes, which was neither his nor his dad's, and of course, nor his mom's.
Good morning, Dad. Good morning, Mom.
Good morning, Anthony.
Huh? That's strange. That means someone has come. Wait a second. Isn't this Josh's shoes? Does that mean Josh is here?
Who else can it be, Anthony?
Oh my God! Josh, it's you!
Anthony was really happy. And why not? After all, it was the best surprise he ever got. Later that night, when Anthony was finally in bed, he looked out of his window when he saw the wishing star again in the sky.
Thank you, dear wishing star. I knew you would do it. You've made this my best Christmas ever.
Anthony had an ardent desire, and he believed that his brother would come, and he received the best Christmas gift ever.
When there is hope, there is always a ray of light in everyone's life.
Never lose hope. And whenever possible, be Santa in someone's life, helping them to continue their journey with hope and faith.
Advent is a time when we await God's intervention in the need of the present day. He intervened then in Jesus' birth. This is the good news, the gospel, God coming down in flesh, pitching a tent here to journey with us on earth. James Irwin, the astronaut of the Apollo 15 mission, said, "God walking on the earth is more important than man walking on the moon." Christmas is a time we celebrate the birth of the Christ the child. I now invite Father Principal to place baby Jesus in the crib and complete the Holy Family.
Thank you, Father Rector, requesting Father Principal to share a few words.
Good morning, my dear students, staff members, and you, my dear parents. We just had a beautiful assembly that had a Christmas backdrop telling us about hope, which has been the theme of this year. Mankind for centuries were waiting in the hope of a Messiah. And 2021 years back, God finally decided to send a person by the name of Jesus on this earth to fulfill that aspiration and that hope. You know, in the church we have two major feasts. One is Christmas, which we celebrate on the 25th of December, the birth of Jesus Christ. And the second major feast is Easter, which comes somewhere in the month of April. There is no fixed date, but it is in the month of April. That is another important feast. And the difference between these two feasts is, for Easter, it is Jesus from the earth going up into the heavens. So we are looking upwards, looking at Jesus going up. But Christmas is different. Christmas is when we are looking up, but we are longing for Jesus from top to come down on earth. More than we looking up, it is God, the creator of the universe, who is looking down on us. Now it's very interesting that the universe is so huge. God could have chose any other Milky Way. He could have chose in this Milky Way any other planet. There are so many other planets, the stars, so many other things. But of all the things in the universe, He chose our Earth to send His Son Jesus. Now, even on the earth, He could have chosen the palace of a king. He could have chosen the richest man on earth. But He chose two very poor people, Joseph and Mary, who didn't even have a house that could take care of their newborn child. They had to go around Jerusalem begging and pleading people. And finally, in Bethlehem, they found a manger. This is God's message to us this Christmas. That God, who is so almighty, who is so great, the creator of the universe, chooses the poor and the lowly. And that is what we need to do at Christmas time. I'm not saying the Christmas tree and Santa Claus and all the sweets that we will make and eat and all the people we will wish, all that is bad. That is not bad, it is good. But let us not forget in all our festivities the essence of Christmas. The essence of Christmas is God from top coming down to earth to the poor and the lowly. Even Jesus, if you see in his lifetime, he did not spend so much time with the rich. Most of his time he spent with the poor people, with people who were sinners, with people who needed healing, people who were sick. And that is why at Christmas time in the school, we teach you this value of caring and sharing. That you may reach out like God reached out to us, humankind. We too may reach out to people who are poor and in need. I'd like to wish you in advance a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Rector, requesting Father Principal to share a few words.
Good morning to each one of you present over here. In the first place, I wish to congratulate the students of Standard 8D for their beautiful performance here on the stage, this assembly. And for this, I also wish to congratulate your class teacher, Ms. Aarti, who ensured a smooth execution of today's assembly. I can see also a few parents present at the assembly along with the other staff members. And I know you are also working silently in the background to ensure a very good assembly today. I think the students of Standard 8D, the last I saw you perform over here live was when you were in the 6th standard, right? You and I have grown now. But the talent is still visible. And I think I mentioned to you last time also, there's a lot of talent in this class, a lot of talent that is abounding, be it in sports, be it in art, in culture, in dramatics. God has blessed you with talent. But that is not enough. And what is important is the manner in which you make use of this talent. And for this, I wish to congratulate you and appreciate all that you do, because you make use of the talent for the good of others. For example, you could have very well told your class teacher, no, I do not want to be a part of this assembly. But here you are acting, singing, playing music, comparing, All because you feel that you're part of Don Bosco, you feel that you're part of the class, and that you need to contribute. So this itself is a beautiful aspect of giving that is so very well brought out during the season of Christmas. Okay, the whole aspect of generosity on reaching out to others. Now I want you also to take a step further. Father Rector kept on reminding us at the online assemblies. He kept on telling others, let it not remain only at your assembly level, but reach out to others when you get the opportunity to do so. I want to congratulate you for your well-prepared assembly, the manner in which you took part in the plays, in the singing, in the playing of the music. Everything was well rehearsed. It was evident. It does not come all of a sudden. Along with Father Rector, the management, the staff, I wish to extend our wishes to you for a Merry Christmas, enjoyable Christmas, joyful Christmas, and a Happy New Year. God bless you.
Wishing you all Merry Christmas and a very happy and prosperous New Year.
Stay happy, stay safe.
Thank you.
I will not get an opportunity again to express our gratitude to the Christmas Panorama team. And I want to take this occasion to say a big thank you to them. Okay, the team comprises Miss Pauline, Miss Dipti, and Miss Jasmine. Of course, they are the core team. Along with them, there are the others. For example, there is a Miss Vichy who ensures a smooth schedule as well as the calculation of points and the winners, etc. The preparation of certificates. So there's an entire staff team that is backing them up. So I wish to congratulate and thank this team for ensuring a different type of a Christmas panorama this year. You know, we always have a very grand Christmas panorama where we get thousands of people visiting this campus. But we cannot have this given the present COVID pandemic condition. But they have ensured that we do not miss out on this Christmas panorama. So I want to say a big thank you to them and to all others who in their own way have contributed to the smooth functioning and the smooth execution of the Christmas Panorama program. Thank you.